Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series, behind the camera this time. What you're looking at, of course, is the old Amerinola. I've got this here in the in my shop with all my Edison machines. And I listen to this machine quite a bit. And, you know, I order cylinders on eBay and I buy them in bulk and I get lots of different cylinders and discs as well. And of course, you're all familiar with the standard discs. The problem with them, of course, is the fact that you have to very carefully center them. And you can get them lined up fairly well. But a lot of these discs sound just like cylinders. They're exactly the same era. And standard discs don't sound all that great, but it's nice to play them when you have them. And if they're in decent shape, they sound okay. This one's a bit worse to wear, but this is the one I've been using for my experiments. So what I did, I've got a small table lathe, so I made some quick measurements, and I took a piece of mahogany, and I made myself a standard adapter for virtually any disc phonograph. And it's just a small piece of wood that I've turned down to the correct diameter. Put the right size hole in the center, and you slip it over the spindle, and then just drop on a standard disc, and instantly perfectly centered. Worked really well. Of course, using wood, eventually, this is going to split. Even though it's mahogany, it's very hard, straight-grained wood. So, using that as my prototype, I made one of aluminum. And I just went up to Home Depot and bought an aluminum rod, not terribly expensive, and then put it on the lathe and turned it down to the correct outside diameter and then drilled the correct hole. And you drop it on any phonograph and you have an instant adapter for a standard record. And this one is a bit worse the wear, but you have to remember these standard discs are quite old. They're the same era as the cylinder, and they sound exactly like Edison cylinders. So in any case, I just wanted to show you the adapter, the original wood prototype. As I said, this is made of mahogany, and you can buy mahogany dowels if you have a small lathe. These are fairly easy to make, a bit time-consuming with all the turning you have to do and drilling the correct hole in the center and then cutting them to size and then rounding the edges. And the aluminum one is even more work, but they do work. And just wanted to show it to you. If you have any standard discs, these things come in really, really handy. And I just keep them, I usually keep the wooden one right there in the Amerinola. And made up a couple of them, and I'm just going to keep them. I've got one for the orthophonic machine, one for the 210, one for the VVIV, and then, of course, the original wooden prototype I keep here in the Amerinola. So just wanted to show you a quick little adapter that you can make for the standard discs. Allows you to play them on virtually any phonograph without having to mess around or try to keep them centered, or I've seen people tape those little yellow inserts originally made for 45s. But this is just, it's easier, it's really efficacious. You can just take them off, turn them over, drop another disc on, no muss, no fuss, always centered, always there if you need it. So, as usual, if you have any questions or comments about the standard adapter, or anything I've covered in my YouTube series, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. Answer all my email, try to answer it the day I get it. Getting a lot of email, mostly questions about the cylinders, the MP3 transfers, and of course the new recorders. But again, if you have any questions or comments about the standard adapter, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.